to recognise that the country has lost confidence in the current system. To restore our faith in Parliament and the good that it can do on the public's behalf, we must commit to tightening up the system of allowances urgently. You know, every MP I know wants to live by the rules, but for too long, some of these rules have been insufficiently clear. So we need to make the rules clear, and we also need to save money. So I'm announcing today urgent proposals to make our system of MPs' allowances and expenses simpler and less generous. Sir Christopher Kelly and the Committee on Standards and Public Life are continuing to carry out an independent review into the system so we can make permanent changes. But I believe we have to act urgently with interim proposals to restore people's confidence that MPs are there to serve the public and not there to serve themselves. And I want a vote to take place to overhaul the current system as early as next week. Now, a detailed written statement setting out our proposals will be made by Harriet Harman, but its main points are the additional costs allowance or second homes allowance should be abolished and replaced by a flat rate daily allowance. This will reflect the fact that MPs do incur extra costs from working in two different places, but it should be based on attendance in the House of Commons. Those ministers who live in official residence would not be entitled to this allowance, nor would MPs within travelling distance of Westminster. They would receive a London supplement similar to London weighting of salaries. The Committee on Standards and Public Life is examining rules governing employment of spouses or other relatives, but in the interim, staff appointed by MPs should without exception become direct employees of the House of Commons, which will now be centrally responsible for their employment terms, conditions, contracts, and the payment of their salaries within the statutory limits allowed, and will have the right to make an audit and independent assessment of such contracts. While the Committee of Standards and Public Life looks into the issue more fully, we'll ensure there is greater transparency on second jobs held by MPs. Where members of Parliament have a second source of income from second jobs, every payment should be declared with a full description of who is paid and what it is for, and who paid it. There shall also be a full declaration of the hours worked for the payment received. I want to discuss these interim proposals with the other party leaders. I hope we can reach consensus. We'll ask the House of Commons to approve them next week. With these changes, I hope that the work of MPs can become recognised again for what it should be, service to the public.